belongs to you. Faith, I'm a saying, hallelujah. Victory belongs to you. Victory belongs to you. All the victory. Victory belongs to you.
Victory belongs to you. Victory belongs. It all belongs to you. Yeah, yeah. Victory belongs. It all belongs to you. Wow. Victory. Victory belongs to you. Victory belongs to you. Victory belongs to you. Victory belongs to you.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
I'm free indeed, in Christ I'm free indeed. No chains are holding me, it's who I choose to be. I'm free indeed, in Christ I'm free indeed. No chains are holding me, it's who I choose to be. I'm free indeed, say.
I'm free indeed, in Christ I'm free indeed.
No chains,
no chains are holding me.
Yes, I hold in me. It's who I choose to be.
I choose to be.
I choose to be free.
I choose to be.
I choose to be.
I choose to be.
Free. In Christ.
Let us. Let us rise on our feet. I can hear and perceive that there is grace in the house this morning. How many of us are sensing it? This morning, in the name of Jesus Christ, you will touch it. I cannot hear that better, amen. I say you will touch that grace in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible tells me about grace multiply. There is no doubt that you are taking grace to the new year. It makes us to realize that it is never too late. Month of November is month of 11-hour miracle. How many of us are ready for it? Wave your hand to the Lord of Lords and shout a living hallelujah. That is that. Shout a grace multiplying hallelujah. We want to thank our wonderful youth choir. They are always a trailblazer, any day, any moment. We appreciate you. May you grow in limp and bond in the name of Jesus Christ. If God is saying that there is grace that is going to multiply today, for every occasion, for every occurrence of God, there is a man he has prepared. And by the special grace of God, he has really prepared a man to minister to us today. And there are no more in person than one of the senior pastors in Lagos Province 59. Let us clap our hands to the Lord of Lords. The father and the mother of youth in Lagos Province 59. The senior pastor of Fountains of Life. And permit me to mention their name, Pastor and Pastor Mrs. Niyi Oluwole, the provincial coordinator of LB59 Youth and Young Adult. As I want to invite the veteran pastor, seasoned pastor, he who has half a record, giant one, right from Lagos Province 25, and is still trending. Yeah. He's still trending. Woo. I say he's still trending. Woo. Even in Lagos Province 59. Woo. Permit me.
That are limiting my destiny this morning in the name of Jesus. Baba, break them, O Lord. Let them be broken completely in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them be completely broken, O Lord. in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Quickly, you will pray this prayer. Say, Father, every barrier of limitation delaying my life, every barrier of limitation holding me down, every barrier of limitation holding down my progress, Father, this morning, let them be removed in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them be removed completely in the name of Jesus. Father, let them be removed. Let them be removed, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Shebi wola mokoko aye mi o Oluwa mo mi mo ibo se fe.
Now sing it spiritually.
Shebi wola mokoko
aye mi o
aye mi.
Now, I want you to sing it spiritually, sing it from your heart. Arenke keke bobo bo sotoro senkere. Rambari bobo senkeke bobo sotoro senkere. Rambari bobo senkeke bobo sotoro senkere. Rekere bobo bo sotoro senkere. Oh yes, from the heart. Thank you,
Lord.
Aha. Submitted ourselves into your hands this morning. According to your will and purpose, Baba, this morning remold our lives. That we will fulfill destinies in the name of Jesus. And that your name only will be glorified in the name of Jesus. Lord, I ask that you open our heart this morning. And you will deposit the seed of your word in it. That it will grow and germinate and bear much fruit, that we shall be the better of it and your name will be glorified. Thank you, Father, this morning. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Let somebody shout hallelujah. God bless you. Please be seated. I want to thank the pastorate for inviting me to come and speak this morning. I also want to say I'm very happy to be here. I greet everybody in the house. It's good to be home again. Home is always sweet. Praise the Lord. Hello, somebody. And, you know, I was a little bit taken aback when I look at the the young man that led the choir. And I know that this used to be a very small boy in those days. Hello, somebody? Well, he's a grown man now. Hello. Praise the Lord. I have been asked to speak on breaking boundaries. And believe you me, I believe God wants to speak to somebody this morning. That this event is taking place today is not a coincidence, but I want to believe that God has prearranged it, that this is the way it's going to be. And when I was preparing for this sermon, I discovered that there is more to it than meets the eye. And I want to bless the person that God has used to bring out this topic. Because this morning, some people are going to receive their deliverance. I say it again. On the authority that is in the name of Jesus, whether the enemy likes it or not, every boundary of limitations in your life shall be broken this morning in Jesus' name. And when I was preparing for this sermon, I discovered that there is more to it than meets the eye. And before I know it, I have written 18 pages. Praise the living Jesus. And I know that the time I have can never be enough for me to deliver a sermon of 18 pages. So I'm going to be precise and concise and expeditious. But you are the one that need to be alert so that you can pick everything God wants to speak to you this morning. Because we are talking about breaking boundaries. And every boundary of limitation shall be broken this morning in Jesus' name. I am taking my own text from Numbers. Numbers 13. If the engineers will help me. Numbers 13. And I'm reading from verse 1. I might be jumping, but I'm reading from Numbers 13. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, Numbers 13, starting from verse 1. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, send out men, that they may search the land of Canaan, which I give unto the children of Israel, of every tribe of their fathers, shall ye send a man, every one of them a ruler among them. And Moses, by the commandment of the Lord, sent them forth, sent them from the wilderness of Paran. All those men were heads of the children of Israel. Praise the Lord. And if you begin to read along, if you read that scripture, I want to jump quickly to verse 25. Verse 25. And they returned from searching of the land after 40 days. And they went and came to Moses and to Aaron and to all the congregation of the children of Israel unto the wilderness of Paran to Kadesh and brought back word unto them and to all the congregation, and showed them the fruits of the land. And they told him and said, we came into the land whither thou sentest us, and surely it floweth with milk and honey, and this is the fruit of it. Nevertheless, the people be strong that dwell in the land, and the cities are walled and very great. And moreover, we saw the children of Anak there. The Amalekites dwell in the land of the south, and the Hittites and the Jebusites and the Amorites dwell in the mountains, and the Canaanites dwell by the sea and by the coast of Jordan. And Caleb stilled the people before Moses and said, let us go up at once and possess it, for we are well able to overcome it. But the men that went up with him said, we be not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger
than we. And they brought up an evil report of the land, which they had searched unto the children of Israel, saying, the land through which we have gone to search it, it is a land that eateth up the inhabitants thereof, and all the people that we saw in it are men of a great stature. And there we saw the giants, the sons of Anak, which come of the giants, and we were in our own sight as grasshoppers, and so we are in their sight. May the Lord bless the reading of his word in the name of Jesus. The story, I'm sure some of us are very much acquainted with it. In the story, when the children of Israel are to possess the land of Canaan, and the spies that they sent, 10 of the spies, they brought a report, because what they saw is boundaries. They saw barriers. But two of the spies says, these barriers can be broken. Praise the living Jesus. And in the process of time, we discovered that because 2 out of 12 determined in their hearts that the barriers had to be broken, at the end of the day, the barriers were broken. The essence of that scripture is to bring to our knowledge that barriers and boundaries exist. Whether you believe it or not, there are boundaries and there are barriers. And today, the Lord will grant us more understanding in the name of Jesus. Boundaries are set almost everywhere you go. And they have their purposes, whether for good or for bad. Praise the living Jesus. Nevertheless, we are more concerned about boundaries that create limitation to the goal and aspiration of individuals. Those boundaries are what we are going to deal with this morning. And I believe God is going to break those boundaries in Jesus' name. So what are boundaries in the first place? They are limit indicators that are set up to either physically or spiritually prevent the extent one can go, whether in life or in a theme. They are limitation indicate, there are limits that have been set. And so boundaries, whether you, no matter how you look at it, are limitations that prevent the extent to which one can go in life. So, and all countries has their boundaries. In fact, Nigeria has a boundary. Recently, we closed our boundary, and surprisingly, countries that have been saying Nigeria is not doing well begin to beg us to open our boundaries. And I say, maybe you people are doing well. We close our boundary. What's the problem? Because they are living on us. They are breaking that boundary to thrive. Praise the living Jesus. And in the process, Nigeria is the one that is suffering for it. I'm decreeing today, the boundaries that has to be broken for you to excel shall be broken this morning in Jesus' name. Now, there are different types of boundaries. Different types, but they are categorized majorly into two. We have physical boundaries, the one we can see. Then we have spiritual boundaries, the one we cannot see with the naked eye. I will talk briefly on physical boundary, then I will also talk briefly on spiritual boundaries. Praise the living Jesus. Both are limitations, one way or the other. And today, by the time we identify the boundaries that exist, you should be able to pick which one is your own, and then pray sincerely that today those boundaries shall be broken in the name of Jesus. Now, talking about physical boundaries, there are several of them. Number one, we have what we call social boundaries. Social boundaries. In all social setups, there are boundaries set up by individual social status.
Praise the living Jesus. And these boundaries are set up to create class. That's why you find out the rich always stay together in one place. And they decided that, okay, let us make a place that is conducive for us. And therefore, they create a social status. Praise the living Jesus. Then you also find out that as a result of this social strata, these social boundaries that have been created, the poor also aggregate themselves in some what we can call a slum. Praise the living Jesus. However, if you find yourself in a situation whereby there's a social boundary preventing you from moving forward, then you must be ready to break it. There's nowhere it is written in the Bible that you must remain at the lower ebb or that you must remain poor. Those who are rich, those who have created a social class for themselves, they don't have two heads. And if you can identify why you are where you are, and you understand that you are where you are, and you know that there is need for you to move forward, then there is need for you to do something about it. Any child of God that finds himself or herself in a slum rather than where life is more comfortable must try to break the social barrier. Praise the living Jesus. You know, it is good for you to go out to other places and see what is obtainable. If you stay too long in a locality, you begin to believe that all whatever exists in that locality is all there is that exists. But let me tell you one thing. Praise the living Jesus. What you consider so important in your local setting, when you move up the social strata, you will discover that it is nothing to write home about. Praise the living Jesus. So if you have been limited by the social class that has been created, and you are beginning to think that maybe I should just be comfortable with where I am, this is the time for you to change. Praise the living Jesus. Remember, in the Bible, the same Bible we are both reading, after the search of this land, hello, somebody? It took 40 years for them to enter the land. They were in that spot for 40 years. If you read the book of Deuteronomy chapter 1 from verses 1 to 3, engineers, Deuteronomy chapter 1 from verses 1 to 3, the Bible tells me that there is 11 days journey when they cross Jordan to Mount Seir, just 11 days. And when you move to the next chapter, I said, after the 48th year, after 40 years, what we read is in Numbers 13. But in Deuteronomy chapter 1, the Bible says that they stood in that place for what? For 40 years. Let me tell you one thing. Okay, Layewa. Hello, somebody? Whatever boundary that has been created, whether by legislation, I don't even want to know, and you find yourself in a place where you should not be, you have to pray your way to breakthrough. Praise the living Jesus. And that's why I'm believing God that every social boundary or boundaries created by unknown barriers or known barriers shall be broken today in the name of Jesus. Social boundaries can also be created academically. They can be created financially. They can be created by so many factors. It is your duty to identify which of the boundaries you are confronted with, and then you move forward and break it. Let me talk briefly, let me accelerate and talk about another physical boundary, which is the human boundary. Human beings can be a barrier to what you want to become. And I must say, this is very vital. When you have human barrier can also be multifaceted. It can be in several forms. We have what we call parental barrier. We are a parent deliberately, whether out of ignorance or out of lack, created a barrier for their children. We have seen it several times, and it's happening. Some parents are barriers to their words due to what they did and what they did not do. In 1 Samuel chapter 2, if you read from verse 22 to 25, 1 Samuel chapter 2, the Bible talks about Eli and his two children. And the Bible tells us that because he did not put them right, he did not correct them properly, they ended up to be bad. Praise the living Jesus. Just as we have some parents that are barriers to the future of their children. A parent that refused to educate their children has already created a barrier. Because there is educational barrier. When you do not educate your children, when you do not give them the necessary education, already you have created a barrier for them. Praise the living Jesus. Now, recently they discovered some locked up, centers where some parents deliberately took their own children and dumped them there. And I was wondering, what kind of a parent would do that to a child? Why will a parent take his own child to a place to be locked up for years and then mortgage the future of that child? Praise the living Jesus. Why will a parent decide that rather than to train the children, they turn the children to what I can call money-making machine. Praise the living Jesus. They tell the children to... There was a case of a young girl that we saw some years back. This girl, every morning, in those days, they would give her 50 naira. 50 naira. And this girl must return back home with 250 naira. The parent will give her 50 naira. And she's to return home with what? 250 naira in those days. Now, what she does is to use that 50 naira to buy a pack of pure water. And that's what she must sell. She must sell 5 of it in a day and come back with 250 naira. And they will collect the 200 naira from her. The following day, they give her another 50 naira. And those are parents. Now, terrible things are happening in this country. We have seen parents that sold their children for money. We have seen parents that because of their own laziness mortgage the future of their children. My prayer for you and for me today is that any parental barrier that has been created in your life shall be broken this morning in Jesus' name. You had better say a better amen. Amen. So, if you find yourself in such a situation, it is time for you to break that barrier. Many things is happening, and I'm believing God that God is going to use somebody here to break barriers in Jesus' name. Even though if you are not trained by your children, you can train yourself. Anyone who wants to break barriers must be ready to train himself. Praise the living Jesus. Let me tell you a story. It might even sound new to my wife now because I've not told her before. I was walking along the road one day and I met an elderly brother. When I was young, he was a senior brother to us when I was young. We all grew up in Ebutemeta. And we greeted each other, and he said, you are a baby. I said, yes. And as I was going, he said, Nii, come. I wanted to give him money. But he said, please, I should not give him money. He said, he has a child, a son, and he cannot train the child. He confessed to me. He said, what can I do to help that child? And I said, okay, let the child come. And I saw the boy, and I asked him, how old are you? He told me his age. He has finished secondary school and he cannot go further. And he said, my parents cannot take care of me. And I said, okay, what I will do for you is that go and get form. I gave him money to get form. He got the form, he came back. I said, okay, what do we do? You will come in to work on my site. You will work on the site. I will help you pay. But you will work on my site and you will be paying back gradually. He was more than happy. Today is a graduate. Praise the living Jesus. Of course, he didn't pay everything back.
But the point is that this boy realized that he has a parental barrier. He knew that his parents can never take care of him. Hello? And when he saw the opportunity, he grabbed it. Praise the living Jesus. Hello, somebody? That my parents are not rich or they are not influential is not an excuse for you to remain within the boundaries. You can break that boundaries and become the one that will set them free. Let somebody shout hallelujah. So, boundaries can be created. Let's take the case of Jabez. In 2 Chronicles chapter 4, if you read from verses 9 to 10, 2 Chronicles chapter 4 from verses 9 to 10, Jabez was born in sorrow and the mother named him Sorrow. But one day, he came to understand that he has a parental barrier or boundary and decided to break it. And he seeked the Lord and said, God, my parents cursed me when I was born and I've remained poor. You have to do something about it. And that day, God answered his prayer. So, if you find yourself, I don't know the kind of situation with you, and you are suffering from parental barrier, it's time for you to break it. And I pray the Lord Almighty will assist you to break it in Jesus' name. Another physical barrier that is very prevalent is locational barrier or locational boundary. A boundary that is created by the virtue of where you stay or where you live or where you are born. Praise the living Jesus. No, sometimes your location determines your allocation. In Genesis chapter 12, you read from verses 1 to 4. Genesis chapter 12 from verses 1 to 4. God spoke to Abraham and said, Abraham, where you are, I cannot prosper you there. You need to relocate. And where I can only bless you is only if you relocate away from where you are. And Abraham obeyed and relocated. Today is a different story. Praise the living Jesus. Now, if God can instruct somebody to relocate, it means that it is possible that your barriers that is being created by your locational, by where you are located, can only be solved if you move away from that location. There are some houses also that you might be living in, if you are not very careful, such houses are boundaries and they are barriers. My wife will remember what I'm about to say. Some years ago, about 10 or I wanted to buy land and I called a lawyer. It's late now. And we went to see this man. And I said, well, I'm interested, I want to buy. And he told me, what did I want to do with it? I said, to build a house, of course. He said, okay, if that's the case. He said, let me tell you one thing. If you are going to buy this land to build a house, you cannot build a story building. It has to be bungalow. I said, why? He said, because he says so. And then I look at the face of the lawyer. He looked at my face. I said, that's limitation. He said, those who try it, oh, they know what they are facing. The man is dead now. Praise the living Jesus. Obviously, all those who are living within that estate are operating under locational boundary. He has limited them. And I said, okay, who can build a story building? He said, except that person is my family. That is in his own words. Praise the living Jesus. So I told him, I said, well, that land is not meant for me. Today, the man is dead. So there are locational boundaries. Boundaries that are created where you are located. Boundaries that are created because you are born into that place. For example, those who are born in Borno State, or they have a problem. They didn't create it. Hello? But because that's where they are located, so they have a challenge. And at times, if they do not move away from that place, it might take a long time before they see respite. So, for some, where you are located now is a boundary. And such a boundary will limit. So for you to progress, you have to relocate. Your geographical location also may also be a boundary. Now, I'm saying this
because of the youths. And I want you to take this one home. Praise the living Jesus. Hello, somebody. When I was growing up, I'm a very patriotic Nigerian, and I believe that this country is going to be great. Praise the living Jesus. But I began to have doubts some few years ago when I begin to see the way things are going, and I'm not happy. Therefore, if there's a youth that has talents, that knows that there's no other way for you to realize your talent, you might need to do something about it. Some years back, I'm talking about 10 years, you can, our PSCP knows this story. A young boy in Covenant University was the first to discover what is WhatsApp today. What is WhatsApp today? He was the first. When he did that thing in school then, he was using it among the students. And he took it to the lecturer that anybody can use it, that he just, they said, this boy is not serious. He said, you are wasting your time. They sent you to come and study. What you are doing is that you are doing something, you are, because the lecturers cannot understand it then. And they killed that dream. Some few years after, WhatsApp came. And it's exactly what that boy discovered. If that boy has not been geographically located here, it will be a different story. Praise the living Jesus. Therefore, I'm speaking to the youths. Hello? If you know that it might be difficult for you, I didn't say you should stay away to abroad. Hello? You can look for immigration working visa or a scholarship where you can study and prosper and realize your dream. When you realize the dream, there's nothing wrong in you coming back to come and what? To come and, you know, benefit your community. But For some people, if you remain here, your dream will die with you. Praise the living Jesus. Praise the living Jesus. I am talking from experience, and maybe with the permission of my wife, I want to give this thing. I want to tell you a classical example of what I'm talking about. My son graduated from the University of Lagos, and he read mechanical engineering. And in his project, he invented an agro-allied machine. Hello? This machine can process snail without you having to just push the snail inside, and it will remove it, and then all the shell will be removed, everything will come out. Then I was wondering, how come nobody thought about it? He was sponsored by the university to go to Abuja for an exhibition, and he went there. The minister came, he shook his hand, he explained to them, they all went. That was the end of the story. The machine is lying waste in the University of Lagos there. Praise the living Jesus. And the boy was very, I said, look, God will help us. That is something that I think that the government should be interested in. Praise the living Jesus. I graduated from the University of Lagos. Once in a while, we go into the mechanical department. Let me tell you one thing. Professor Awojobi, he did Autonov 1, Autonov 2, Autonov 3, Autonov 4, Autonov 5, to Autonov 10. He has the blueprint on the ground. He only constructed Autonov 1. Hello, somebody? One day, the files were missing. And a prototype of what he invented began to come out from Russia and Germany. Let me tell you one thing. May you not be wrongly geographically located. Even if you are, you can do something about it. You can break the boundaries. You are going to rise on your feet. Because this thing bothers me, and it should bother you. If you think you are settled, how about your children? You should think about them. You will lift up your hands and pray this prayer and say, Father, every limiting barriers as a result of where I was born, Father, today, the grace to break it
release it into my life in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I pray for you and for me. The grace to break geographical barriers, the Lord will give unto us in the name of Jesus. Please be seated. So, for the youth, you can try visa lottery. You can try Canadian immigration working visa. Check out overseas scholarships. Look for one that can help you to get out of the shores of this country, at least to realize your dream. The same boy, when he was doing his youth service, he said, Dad, I would like just to be, making machines. Then he invented another machine. Hello? I wish he's not born here. Praise the living Jesus. And he showed it to me. I said, he even asked me to get him some people who can weld. It has to do with construction. You know what he did? He was able to, he put it on the internet and somebody bought it for $500,000. Now, what I'm saying is that you can also help yourself. Don't allow the boundaries that have been created to limit you. What you need to do is, we are going to talk about very soon, the virtues of boundary breakers. So that you begin to look beyond outside the box. And as you do that, the Lord God Almighty also will grant you grace to be able to do it in Jesus' name. Another physical boundary is financial boundaries, which is very common. In Genesis chapter 26, if you read from verse 12, Genesis 26 from verse 12, the Bible says that Isaac was living in a land and there was famine. And he had nothing and he wanted to move away. And God said, look, don't move. Just go and plant, go and sow. I will bless it. And the Bible tells us that he sowed and he reaped 100-fold. Now, if you must break financial barriers and boundaries, you must learn how to invest. The solution to breaking financial boundaries is what? It's investments. Because nothing ventured, nothing gained. No matter how professional you may be, because professionals at times believe that they can live on their profession. But let me tell you one thing. There will be a limit you can never go beyond, except you go on investment. You must have what we call an entrepreneurial skill, a skill to become an entrepreneur. You must have it in order to break every financial boundaries that might have been set. Because the Bible says we should walk and pray, not pray and walk. And the Bible is not mistaken. Why you put walk first before prayer? If you have no job, and you have your certificate, and you have your skill, the first thing you must do is to look for a job. And then pray. Praise the living Jesus. If you are unemployed, and you have graduated since the days of William Wilberforce, and you are saying, it's the economy, who told you that? Praise the living Jesus. You must, first of all, get yourself busy. When you get yourself busy and you now pray, it is what you are doing that God is going to prosper. Manna doesn't fall from heaven anymore. Hello, somebody? Let me tell you one thing. You can sit down here and pray from now till thy kingdom come. If you don't walk, now hunger go kill you. Hello? But when you have a work in your hand that you are doing, and you spend quality time in God's presence, God is going to multiply it. Look, by grace, I have read the Bible from Genesis to Revelation. I have discovered that in every miracle that God performs, he always asks for something. Hello? If he asks for something. Yeah, my friend, waiting there your hand. It's a rod. Who told you it's a rod? That is a staff of power. Stretch it forward and speak the word. Moses asked to circulate before the Red Sea was divided. You think God cannot say, Red Sea divide without asking Moses to do anything? Of course he can. Praise the living Jesus. In fact, Let me tell you one thing. It was that act that also made Moses over assumption. Praise the living Jesus. The Bible tells us that when the children of Israel were thirsty and they needed water, God told Moses, use the rod in your hand to touch the rock. And he did. And there was water at first. Second time, when they have the same problem, God says, speak the word. I didn't ask you to use the rod. But because he assumed, hello, he did not only hit the rock once, he hit it twice. And that rock was Jesus. Because of that, he missed the promised land. You will not miss your promised land in Jesus' name. What am I saying? Finances has been the major barrier to most people. And we need to break it. The basic things of life is food, housing, and security. Praise the living Jesus. But if you do not break the barriers, you will live in abject poverty. In Nigeria, it's survival of the fittest. Take it for now. And youths in the house, don't blame anybody for anything. It is in your hand to do what you know you can do to survive. Don't steal. Don't do 419. And don't do Yahoo. But you can transform your experience. You can transform your skill, your talent to making money. Praise the living Jesus. And that means you must what? You must invest. I remember that when we are in Builders, we used to preach on things like this. But you know that almost all the youths were building houses. They are not yet married though. Hello? I cannot count the number of houses or foundation I went to dedicate. For youths, they are young, they are not yet married. Praise the living Jesus. Then you ask me, how are they doing it? It's investment. There is something in your hand that you can invest. Hello? Something is right in your hand. It's only that you have not paid attention to it. If you must break financial barriers, then you must look at areas outside the box that you can invest and make money. You can seek the assistance of those who could give you what we call a quantum push. Everybody, one time or the other, may require what we call a quantum push. In other words, you get an assistance somewhere. Like the boy that I told you came to me, what I gave to him was a quantum push, and he did the rest. Praise the living Jesus. I only helped him to pay the fees, and he will come and work. I would say, don't you have lectures? He said, sir, don't worry. When I get to school, I will copy. But I need to make money. Because what I did for him is that every work he did, they divide it into two. He take half home, he pay half back. But when he got to a stage and I saw his tenacity, I said, don't collect anything from him again. Praise the living Jesus. Today is a graduate. So you need a quantum, and that is where you need to pray for that quantum push to come. Hello, somebody? What is a quantum push? It's an opportunity that comes your way. I'm going there very soon because of time. I have to be expeditious. Let me be fast. Praise the living Jesus. You know, when I was preparing this sermon, my wife told me that, oh, God, you are writing too much. You will now start rushing it. I said, look, God will help me. Now, enough of physical barrier. Let us talk about spiritual barriers. And this is why I want you to pay much, much attention. I would have loved to speak more on physical barriers, but because of time. Let us go to spiritual barriers now. Praise the living Jesus. Hello, somebody. Every generational curse that is limiting your growth today, they shall be removed. The curses shall be broken. In the mighty name of Jesus. Whether you believe it or not, there are spiritual barriers and boundaries that the naked eye can never see. But how do we know they manifest into the physical? Hello? The Bible tells me in the book of Joshua that when Joshua conquered the city, he said, anyone that build this city, he will lay the foundation with his firstborn. And by the time he completed it, the second one will go with it. And it was so. The sons of the prophet, they look at Elijah. They say, Elijah, This town is so good. But the water is what? Generational cursing. Because in Joshua cursed that land and he reversed it. Every generational curses that is creating a boundary or barriers for you shall be removed today in the name of Jesus. In Isaiah chapter 49, engineers, you will help me. Isaiah 49, from verse 24 to 26. Isaiah 49, 24 to 26. Quickly, can we have it on the screen? Isaiah chapter 49, Isaiah 49, from verse 24 to 26. The Bible says, can be prayer be taken away from the mighty or a lawful captive delivered? But the Bible also tells me that God says the Lord that even a lawful captive can be delivered and the prayer of the terrible can still be taken away. Because when God decides to act on your part, every boundary or barrier shall be broken. I pray for you and for me today. The boundaries that are created by our ancestors, by our fathers, by our generations that have gone before us shall be broken today in the name of Jesus. Like I said, spiritual boundaries are the ones you cannot see with the naked eyes. Some of it are generational, environmental. Some are even self-inflicted. Some are curses and covenants, and so on and so forth. When we are talking about generational boundaries or generational curses, it means that the generation in which you come from has created a boundary of which you are not even privy to. Some time ago, while we are still in builders, I think I delivered a sermon that has to do with generational curse. And I told them what they call spiritual mapping. Praise the living Jesus. And this brother, he sat down, and after the sermon, he said, Pastor, this is what is happening in my family. Anytime they reach this particular age, they die. Especially those who are well-to-do. Once they reach that age, they what? And I said, well, he said, I am about to reach that age. What you just told me now, I just look at it. I said, really? Thank God you came. So I said, you are going to go for 3 days fasting and prayer. And I gave him prayer points. And I asked the minister to join him in prayer. And when he was about, I said, come, don't go yet. Let me warn you. He said, what? I said, somebody will still die. I said, somebody will still die. He said, why do I say that? Because it's generational. But you will not die. Because the Bible tells us that God says he will visit the iniquity of the father upon the children up to the what? The fourth generation. But he also says in that same scripture that he will have mercy on thousands of them that fear him. And he started the prayer. The following day, thank God he came that day. The following day, he ran to me. He said, Pastor, it has happened. I said, what happened? He said, my uncle just died. We are about the same age. And no, my cousin just died. He said, we are about the same age. He said, he's a little bit older than me, so he has already reached that age. I said, that's what we call spiritual substitution. Praise the living Jesus. The covenant has been made in the days of William Wilberforce and Mungo Park. And at the mature age of that covenant, the devil must come and take whatever he wants to take. If he cannot take A, he will take B. And what we just did is just we did what we call spiritual substitution. Because it's a generational curse, but it's broken on your head now. Therefore, some people are suffering for things that does not concern them. I think it was Pastor Bola Odutola. He went for one deliverance. That time he was our area pastor. And he told us this story, that they called him to come and pray for a girl. As he was entering, the girl mentioned his name. He said, what? This little girl, how do you know my name? The girl laughed. The girl was about 14 or 15 years old. The girl mentioned his name. He mentioned the name of his father. He mentioned the name of his grandfather. Then he sat down. Then the girl was telling him, he said, where were you 500 years ago when they make a covenant with me? There are some barriers that have been created, boundaries that have been created by our ancestors. And they are generational. And you have to break them. I pray every generational boundaries and causes shall be broken today in the name of Jesus. How do you know whether you are suffering from a generational curse? You do what we call spiritual mapping. You look at what has happened to your sister or your senior brother or your father or your mother or your uncles or your aunties. You look at If you are also following the same trend, if you see that the same trend is happening to you, then that means there is a generational curse, and you might need to go for deliverance. If you are seeing premature death and things like that, and it seems to be happening steadily at a particular stage in a family, then you might need to pray. Let us leave that one and move to environmental boundaries. Now, like I said, it's also a physical and a spiritual boundary. And the best solution, like I said, is to locate. Environmental boundary might be created by the powers that are occupying a particular location. Whether you like it or not, there are principalities and there are powers and there are rulers of darkness of this world. And also there are spiritual wickedness in high places. That's Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12. And the Bible tells us about them. And the Bible said the only way to overcome this one is by putting up the complete and the whole armor of God. Hello? My wife will laugh now. We live in a house for 13 years. In that 13 years, I almost lost everything I brought there. And my wife used to tell me, that time I wasn't born again anyway, but she was. At least, she prayed more than me. She will be telling me anytime she's going to that house, she will see a barrier like all these local boundaries they normally do in the village. That's what she will see. I said, what? I consider it nonsensical. And we were in it for 13 years. And along the line, of course, I became spiritual too, and I know how to pray. And things, one day the landlord came out and said, no, what first of all happened was that the daughter of the man became born again. Hello, and she used to come to us. So we are now teaching her how to read the Bible, how to understand the Bible. And in the process of time, she discovered that her father kept some calabashes in the house. So when the man went out, they took the calabashes and they broke it. As soon as they broke the calabash, the man knew where he was, that the things had been broken. So he came back. He couldn't talk because he couldn't find it. And the children, the lady has taken it out. Then one day he now said, there are some things he has buried inside this compound, though. It was then I knew that we had been delivered. Of course, before we left that house, everything we lost, we got it back. But it's by spiritual warfare. If you find yourself in a place like that, whether you like it or not, you have to fight spiritual warfare or you relocate. There are also some spiritual barriers that are self-inflicted. You inflicted on yourself by joining cults, by joining the Ogboni Conference of Fraternity, by joining all this so-called power society that has no power. Remember, the Bible says, the gods that did not create the heavens and the earth shall perish. Therefore, they are not gods. If you have joined a cult in school, you are under spiritual bondage. And that is a fact. Praise the living Jesus. Sometimes ago, when we are still in Builders, a brother came to me. In fact, he's the only family that we went to their house for vigil. I don't normally go to people for what, but this is the only family we did vigil in their house. And I asked him, all these challenges, he said his father belongs to a cult. And since he became born again, he had decided to leave the cultish society. And I said, what about when you were in school? He said he was a Babanla cultist. So I probed further. I said, were you involved in a hit? He said, yes, sir. And some people died. Praise the living, but he's now born again. Now, but he has to pay the consequences of those sins. Let me tell you one thing. Listen to today. The scripture will not be written because of anybody. Every man, the Bible says, a sinner will not go what? Unpunished. Now, every man will bear the consequences of their sin, even when it has been forgiven them. Now, the only difference is that when your sins are forgiven you, it cannot stand against you in the day of judgment. But the repercussion of those sins you have committed, one day, is going to strike you in the face. If it doesn't happen to you, it will happen to your generations coming. It's a fundamental spiritual law. Nothing can, it doesn't change. It's a fundamental spiritual law. Praise the living Jesus. So that's why the Bible says, he that is doing good, continue doing good. If you are doing bad, continue doing bad. Because God knows that no sinners will go unpunished. Hello, somebody. I pray for you and for me. The sins that we do not know about, the causes associated with it, will not reign in our life in the name of Jesus. So, if you are a lawful captive, according to Isaiah chapter 49, verse 24 to 26, maybe you have even raped somebody before, and you think you have gotten away with it. Babala lie! You think you have gotten away? Oh, you raped somebody. And because nobody knows, oh, you feel you have gotten away. Let me tell you one thing. Even if you become pastor, one day, the consequences of that sin is going to strike you in the face. Some people brought no spiritual barrier to them because they involved in 419, he also called Yahoo, or disobedient to parents, all form of unrighteous acts. Let me tell you one thing. The person doing Yahoo or 419 has taken somebody's money. That person may have lost his life because of it or enter into a stroke and die. So the money is blood money. And you don't expect God to allow grace to increase. The Bible says we cannot wall up in sin and expect the grace of God to abound. Therefore, if you find yourself on a self-inflicted spiritual bondage, it is time for you to break free by seeking the solution, by confessing your sin completely, by seeking the Lord for deliverance, and accepting Him as your Lord and Savior. Another spiritual barrier is curses and covenants, which I've already explained before. But a parent can curse a child, as we see in the case of Jabez, and a parent can bless a child, as we see in the case of Isaac and Jacob and his children. Praise the living Jesus. So, I pray for you. That's why they used to tell us that children must make sure that they receive the blessings of their parents. Let me tell you one thing. Your parents has a spiritual authority over you. Hello? Especially your father. If your mother curses you, your father can cancel it. If your father curses you, your mother can cancel it. Because there is a spiritual hierarchy. But if your father curses you, your pastor, because of a higher spiritual authority, can what? Can break it. If your pastor curses you and you go to your general overseer, he can break it. If your general overseer curses you, no ways, you go to God directly, God will remove it. But when a man, that's why the Bible says it's a dangerous thing to fall into the hands of what? If God decided that a person is cursed, yes, because God can, only God can overrule himself. May the Lord help that person. That's why the Bible talks about sin that is unto death and sins that is not unto death. That is not the topic for discuss today, so that I don't digress. Praise the living Jesus. So, if you are suffering from spiritual barriers as a result of curses and covenants, seek the Lord for deliverance, and the Lord will deliver us in Jesus' name. Now, for those who want to break boundaries and break barriers, what should be their qualities? What should be their virtues? And that's where we are going to end because of time. Praise the living Jesus. Anyone who wants to be a boundary breaker or a barrier remover must first of all have the knowledge of what that barrier is. So knowledge is number one. What you don't know, you don't know. Hello, somebody? What you don't know, you don't know. You must have knowledge about the barrier and how to remove it. That's the second phase. A boundary breaker must be knowledgeable enough to be able to identify the boundaries and the limitations that are confronting his life. This is extremely vital before any positive results can be achieved. The Israelites, in Joshua chapter 6, verses 1 to 5, Joshua chapter 6, verses 1 to 5, they realize that there is a barrier that they need to pass through when they want to enter Jericho, because there is a war. Praise the living Jesus. And this war according to how it was described in some study Bible, is so big and is so tall that you can drive a chariot on top of it. Praise the living Jesus. And they knew that they do not have the resources to break this barrier. But they know they have a God. So they went to God. And God told them what to do. Now, I read a book some years back. The man was writing that book, and he said he had an encounter with an angel. And the angel told him that he was present when the wall of Jericho fell down. Praise the living Jesus. And so he asked the angel, how did you do it? And the angel said, I will tell you today. Let me tell you one thing. There are some barriers. Except God remove it, there's nothing you can do. Hello? The angel told the man, he wrote a book. It's a Chinese man, I forgot his name. He said, go and read your Bible very well. The Bible says the wall of Jericho fell down flat, right? Now, if the description we had in the Bible is what to go by, we were told that the wall is so tall and it's so wide. Even if it's false, it will still be a very big heap to climb. But the Bible says it fell down flat. He said what they did was that they sank the wall. They sank the wall that the children of Israel was able to pass on a plain level. Now, only God can do that. Hello? Maybe your mountain must sink. Some may have to be blast off. Some may have to be, to be made to disappear. I don't know. But you must have a knowledge that there's a barrier there. So that even when you pray, and when you are seeking for assistance, you know what you are seeking assistance for. Hello? Hello, somebody? My wife has a friend. Hello? Hello, somebody? And she has come of age and there is no husband. And they live downstairs. We live upstairs. And she knew there's a barrier. For the first time in my life, I saw a woman that had VG for 365 days. She did a VG for how many years? For how many days? A whole 365 days she was always having VG. Every day we used to hear her. We live upstairs. Of course, God answered. Praise the living Jesus. It depends on how much knowledge you have about your barrier before you know how to overcome it. If you don't consider it a barrier, it remains there. Because ignorance is what the devil wants. Therefore, if you must remove those boundaries and barriers, you need knowledge. Number two, qualities of those who must be a boundary breaker is that you must be determined to break it. Just like Jabez in 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 9 to 10. There must be a determination. What do we mean by determination? You must be determined to move forward. You must not allow temporary comfort to blindfold you from going forward. Jabez knew that there is a problem and he was bent on what? On solving the problem. And it was solved. It was solved. Breaking boundaries and barriers of limitations require rugged determination. And you must be a custodian of one to be able to achieve it. The ability to pursue a purpose until it is achieved, no matter what it takes or cost, is what we call determination. In 2 Kings chapter 7, if you read from verses 3 to 4, 2 Kings chapter 7, from verses 3 to 4, the Bible tells us about lepers who says, look, if you go to the camp of the enemy, we will die. If we stay here, we will die. Why can't we just go into the camp of the enemy and see whether we even get something to eat? They were determined and they went and they lived and they brought also relief to others. Number three, because of time. A boundary breaker must be dedicated to what he's doing. Dedication is the quality of being devoted or committed to a cause or something. If you look at the case of Joseph and Potiphar, even though he was a slave in Potiphar's house, he was dedicated to the duties. And that dedication earned him a position in that house. Even because of that dedication, he was sent to prison. And when he got to the prison yard, he was still what? Dedicated. And God singled him out. What about David, the shepherd boy? The Bible says that when Samuel went to Jesse's house to anoint a king, he was looking for great people. Even the father of David does not consider him important. But God noticed a shepherd boy in the bush. And God noticed how he used to take care of the sheep. And God said, this is the quality I need. You must be dedicated to what you are doing. You must do it with all your might, with everything you've got. You must give it 110%. Even if you are in an employment, maybe you are employed, you are working under somebody, you must be dedicated to your duty to be able to earn what we call a blessing. Praise the living Jesus. Dedication is a quality of those who must break barriers. Number four is that you must also be focused. A barrier or a boundary breaker must be focused. This is the ability of looking at the end result and not minding what it may cost or the means of getting it. Because the means will be taken care of by determination. You must be able to know that this is where I am going and I want to get there. If you do not have if you are not focused or you do not have a goal, anyone that is focused will set a goal. You must have a vision. This is what I want to do. This is what I want to become. If you have no vision, then there is no barrier to break. If you have no goal, there's no barrier to break. So you must set goals for yourselves. You must set something that you can be working on progressively for yourself. At times, little success distracts some people. Hello? Somebody is going to laugh now when I talk this now. Hello, somebody? We were in a church some time ago, some years back. Hello? And then the pastor is a CAC church. So we are the Baba Ijo and Iyaijo and all those ones. Some of them are in the house. Hello? Hello, somebody? And we manage to contribute money and buy a land. Hello, somebody? And we bought this land. Owo Niyo, and we started building. Hello? And we build the house. We build the church. And we move further. We put a boys quarter behind, two-room apartment. My wife used to tell me, he said, that pastor, he's a good one. I said, wait until the man is comfortable. He said, this man is good. I said, okay, I've heard you. Yes, ma'am. Because at that time, I was not totally born again anyway. Then, as the church became progressive and he has seen the structure has stood, then languages like, the stone, his voice started changing. Then one day, I told my wife, I said, one day this man is going to say, if you want to go, go. He said, well, look, because at that time we have built the church and we have built somewhere he can leave behind. He got to a stage, he said, look, hello? Hello, somebody? A pastor said that. You know, when such voices start coming, what he was trying to do is that he felt that at least we have a place now, and I have a place I'm leaving behind. Those who knows the story, he wanted them to leave so that he can now know. Praise the living Jesus. And all sort of dissenting voices started coming. Just because he has seen a small what? A small blessing. A small success. It's the same thing with some people. Small blessings, small success make them to become so arrogantly proud that they think that, they have achieved. It's good to build a house. Hello? Hello? But if your house is in Isongo Ota or Alagbado, hello somebody, remember there are people living in VGC. and Banana Island. Hello, somebody? Which means there is a higher level you can go. I went to a house in Banana Island and I started thinking again that this man doesn't have two heads now. Hello, somebody? And there was a boy, when we were in Builders, he built a house in a half a plot. Every time, he said, in my house, wait, I must see that's your house. I went there, it was a bungalow. And I said, Oga, this is what you built on half plot of a land, and we cannot hear a word. Hello, somebody? Let me tell you one thing. You must have a vision. You must have a focus. You can be better than what you are. And if you don't have that, if you cannot think it, you cannot realize it. There must be a goal that you can set. Praise the living Jesus. Luke chapter 9, verse 62. If engineers will help us. Luke chapter 9, verse 62. Or they have slept. Luke 9. Okay, let's move on. Number 5. If you must be a boundary remover or breaker, you must be creative. Creativity is essential. You want to break barriers. You want to remove boundaries. And you are not creative. A boundary and barrier breakers must be creative. Creativity brings about what we call the halo effect. Hello? And I want to talk a little bit. Creativity brings what? The halo. What it means is that two people can be doing the same thing. Hello? And one can be preferred than the other based on what we call the halo effect. In other words, you have added an extra value to it than what others are doing. Praise the living Jesus. You need to add an extra value, an added value to it. And that has to come from your creativity. Praise the living Jesus. Originally, shoe but aloha now, there's different kinds of shoes. But why is it that some are more expensive than the other? It's because they have added value to some of it. Praise the living Jesus. How come somebody's jewelry is worth $45 million, even though all are stolen? Those, of course, you can use any jewelry. You can just get to the bus and buy a jewelry. But there's something that has been added to that one that gave it what? Value. So creativity is extremely essential for somebody who wants to break boundaries. To be creative, you must first of all go for knowledge. You must study hard. You must be proactive. You must be efficient in whatever you are doing. 2 Timothy 2:15 tells us that we should study to show ourselves approved unto God, a worker that needs to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Because knowledge, of course, is power. To be creative, secondly, you must be ready to share your ideas in a way others can appreciate. Ideas that you have in your head that others cannot access is of no value. Hello? Hello, somebody? If you have ideas, until that ideas is transformed to something that can be understood by those who need it, it's just there for nothing. So you must learn how to present that ideas in a way that people can appreciate it. That's why you discover that people who study arts are very creative. They have this idea in their head, and they find a way to put it in something that you'll be able to watch, to recognize. And then when it comes out, at times it comes out so beautifully, and you begin to wonder, how did they even reason this one out? That's creativity. So you must be creative. You must be able to add value. If you cannot add value, you cannot add the halo effect. Believe you me, 1,001 people also probably want to do the same thing you want to do. Hello, somebody? That's why you cannot remain doing the same thing the same way and expect to get a better result. Technology has taken over. You can search the internet, get to know what are the new things that have been done so that you can also apply it to break boundaries. Number six, quickly. I have two more, then I will round up. Number six qualities or virtues of is diligence. You must be what? You must be diligent. If you are not diligent in what you are doing, you can forget it. Diligence is the ability to be industrious, to be hardworking. Diligence requires a great deal of hard work. And let me tell you, there is no substitute to hard work. If anybody tells you that hard work does not pay, it's a lie. Hard work pays. It pays. You must know that a continuous effort also can bring about a continuous progress. Greatness is consolidated by gains that you make through what? Through steady efforts and diligence. So anybody wants to break boundaries, he must be diligent in whatever he's doing. He must be serious with it. He must be somebody who wants to, reach the stars. Somebody who wants to get there. And number seven qualities is faithfulness. Faithfulness, I describe it this way, that it is dedication that is married with sincerity in whatever you are doing. When your dedication is married with sincerity of heart, sincerity of purpose, then you are faithful. Then you'll be able to break boundaries. If you are not faithful in what you are doing, you can't break boundaries. You can't not even go far. Praise the living Jesus. Praise the living Jesus. I want to tell you a short story, and I will round up. Many years ago, when we constructed this altar, it's not like this. This altar doesn't look like this some years back. And after we finished, the area pastors at that time called me and said, Pastor Luole, I don't want this altar like this. I want this altar to be the way it looks now. Then, many years back. And we were having a workers' vigil. And after the vigil, I came down and I started drawing on the ground how this place will be if we have to break and reconstruct. And one of the workers said, he called my name. He said, Pastor Luole, he said, Brother Luole, I will not say pastor then. You are just too much on a fico of a passenger. You are too effico. What are you doing? We just finished VG and you are already drawing on the ground. I felt a little bit hot that day. Praise the living Jesus. But today, I'm a zonal pastor and he's still a worker. Hello, somebody? That person who said it that day had been a worker before we joined the workforce. Now, what I'm saying is that if you are not faithful with what you are doing, you can't get the reward. You can't get the reward. You must be doing something with the right motives. Your motive must be right. If you want to break boundaries, you must have a right motive. And you must also understand that for you to get, which is the last one I'm going to talk about, if you are not faithful with it, God is not going to respond. I have decided not to bombard you with too many Bible verses. If not, we won't live here. Because the Bible tells me that faithfulness in something that is little will be counted as faithfulness in something that is what? That is big. So if you are not faithful in a little thing you are doing, God cannot reward you with big things. He will not even commit it into your hand. Praise the living Jesus. And finally, as we round up, is the God factor. The God factor. Anybody who wants to break boundary needs God. And that is the ultimate. I reserve the best for the last. In John chapter 15, verse 5, engineers, if you can help us. John 15, verse 5. God told us, he said, we are the branches of his vine. And he said, we abide in him, and he abide in us. He said, without him, there's absolutely nothing we can what? We can do. He said, I am the vine. Here are the branches. He that abideth in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, you can do what?
Nothing.
If you want to break boundaries, you want to remove barriers, you need God. Jesus said, he said, come unto me, all ye that labor and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. The Bible tells me that the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are saved. He is the same God that we are serving. And he is the same God you are in his presence. I receive from my spirit today, as I'm coming here, that there is somebody in this auditorium today. The challenges of your life, by this time next Sunday, will become testimonies. Hello, somebody. Let me share it with the when we were praying. Some years back, we were in a workers' meeting, and the fuel got finished in the generator and the light went off. And I said, what happened? Didn't you buy fuel? They said the person to buy the fuel has not come. So I called a brother. I said, Oga, come, go and buy us fuel. Take your car and go and buy fuel. He laughed. I said, why are you laughing? He said, Pastor, I don't have a car. I said, really? But I used to see you with a car. Ah, only I should reach it too. I used to borrow it. It's not my own. I said, really? You don't have a car? He said, yes. And I lift my voice to heaven. I said, as long as the Lord liveth, by this time next Sunday, God will give you a car. And he said, amen. Believe you me. On Wednesday, he came with the key of a car. Wednesday. He didn't reach Sunday. Wednesday. So when a prophetic statement comes in, you better key into it. There's somebody in this auditorium. By this time next Sunday, the challenges and the boundaries that are limiting you, they will become testimonies. If you believe it, say a better amen. Rise on your feet. It's time for us to rise on our feet. I want you to close your eyes. There is somebody here who has not given his life to Jesus. For you to break boundaries, I have told you, you need God. Without God, you can do nothing. If you want to give your life to Jesus, so that you can become a boundary breaker and a barrier remover, just come forward quickly so that I can pray with you, and then the rest of us can pray. You want to give your life to Jesus quickly, just come forward and stand before the altar. For the rest of us, I want you to pray this prayer and say, Father, say, Father, as it is written, that the name of the Lord is a strong tower, and the righteous run into it and they are saved. Every boundary of limitation, every barrier of limitation, limiting me and keeping me in one place, Father, today, let them be broken to irreparable pieces. In the mighty name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray.
You can lift up your voice. This is not the time to negotiate. The violence, take it by force. It's the day of John the Baptist. Everything that wants you to be retrogressive, God has given you the power to step and trample upon snake and scorpion. And over everything, nothing can stop you and your children. It shall be well with you. Heavens have answered your prayer. No more limited boundaries. No more limitation. From today, you are moving forward. Everywhere they said demotion, you are getting promotion. Anywhere they said no way, you are having multiple channels. Anywhere they say no alert, you are having double alert. Anywhere they say your children fail, your children will excel. Anywhere they say your children will not get married, they will get married. In the name of Jesus. Anywhere they say no contract for you, you have multiple contracts. Anywhere they say no project for you, multiple project is coming. Anywhere they did not award you certificate of completion, you are getting your certificate in the name of Jesus. Anywhere they say there is no shoe for you to dance, you are dancing with a new shoe. Anywhere they say there is no garment or praises for you, you are getting a new garment. it shall be well with you. Your story will change. You are lifting up. Between now and next week Sunday, you will have a resounding testimony. You will be the next celebrant in the name of Jesus. So shall it be. We pray for the servant of the Lord. God will renew him. God will renew you, Daddy. God will renew Mommy. God will strengthen him. Everything he has labored for, he will sit down in good health with Mommy, and they will eat and they will praise the Lord in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for what you have done. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Shout hallelujah! Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's give God a big hand. Daddy, God bless you. Mommy, God bless you. Amen. Daddy, it's as if you should not finish this sermon. Hallelujah. And as we were preaching, I was telling Mommy and Mommy Zuna, I said, Daddy is coming back in December. Should Daddy come in December? Daddy, I'm not the one, no. I only move emotion. And spiritually, the borders have been removed. Let's clap for Jesus. As we bring out our offering and tithes, like we shared during the first service, those of you who are not around, I attended a party yesterday. Daddy, I went to a party yesterday. The party, oh lele. Tell your neighbor, your party will be lele. The husband was 80 years old. The wife was 65. All the five children, firstborn, lawyer in Tota. Secondborn, accountant in Mobi. Thirdborn, aeronautic engineer in U.S. Fourthborn, medical doctor, neurosurgeon in Canada. Fifthborn just said, I want to be a caterer. Job is sending money to me. Only 200 of us were invited. Daddy, you know what they did at the wedding at Chevron Drive? One for one code, Tamafiwole code. The first code you will give them at the first gate is called celebration. If you don't say celebration, they will not allow you to enter. Second gate, the next code is jubilation. The third gate, you have to say recreation. Nigbati Mosheton, I was recreated. I decree the name of Jesus. When your children will celebrate your birthday, all of them will be standing well financially. When you are celebrating your 75th birthday, 78, 65, 60, 55, 45, all your children will be well doing in the name of Jesus. On your party day, you will put code in the IV, code. Because those that you are not invited, they will not come. I say, so shall it be in the name of Jesus. Since yesterday, I have not eaten. I'm still fasting. Because the food they gave me, I don't want to go to the toilet. I want to be saliving. As if I should just be going like that. It shall be well with us in Jesus' name. Let the titles come forward as the choir will be singing. Bring out your praise offering. Bring out your Sunday love offering. And the Lord will bless you. Choir, quickly.
Hallelujah. Ko so papire, ko si papire, ko ma solo rubire.
Igwe.
Ko papire, ko si papire, ko ma solo rubire.
Igwe.
E ma mi gbala ru to bi.
Go!
Oye di kagi, oye di kachuku, o malicha, atone chepawa.
Uneya,
elu,
une chisa,
elu,
o kuneya,
elu.
Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, I want to bless you for your children, for their tithe and offering, their seed, their praise seed, and their seed of praise. Thank you, Lord, for this opportunity to give out of the abundance you have given us. Thank you, Lord, that we are not giving at the burial ground. Thank you, Lord, we are not in the mortuary. Thank you, Lord, we are in the sanctuary of praises. Thank you, Lord, for another opportunity to be here as givers. Lord, let our life be a giving life in the name of Jesus. We pray, oh Lord, before we leave this auditorium, let there be a lot for the response to our giving in the heavens boundaries in the name of Jesus. Let there be open heaven upon our head. By the time we come back next week Sunday, let our testimony be so overwhelming. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Let somebody give God a big hand. God bless you. If today is your first time of worshiping here with us, as we round up the service, you are worshiping here with us for the Sunday like this, can you signify by raising up your hand? Today is your first time of worshiping here with us. Anybody here worshiping with us, first timer, I want to welcome you. Don't be shy, I want to welcome you to our midst. Any first timer here? Is there anybody? Can I see anybody worshiping here? Hallelujah. Let's clap for our brother coming from the back. Amen. Let's welcome.
Fearfully made, fearfully made. You are welcome in Jesus.
Gethsemane Chapel. This is where God answers our prayer. Today is our Youth Sunday on 2nd and 5th Sunday. This is where we have our youth service. And it's so glamorous to see you as youth in our vineyard that God Almighty has sent you to be a partaker of this glorious blessing. This month is our month of refreshing ahead. We are refreshing ahead. And may you remain refreshed from this time on in the name of Jesus. Let's clap for them as they go to this special seat on your left. And the Lord will bless you as we show you a little bit of our hospitality. You're welcome. Quickly, the ushers will be giving us two copies of this flyer. Please, let's give all members. We are to invite two people next week, Sunday. And the theme for our November is called Refreshing Ahead. Let someone say, Refreshing Ahead. Say, Refreshing Ahead. Oh, you're not speaking louder. Say, I'm refreshed ahead. Amen. So please, don't keep it in your Bible. Invite two new people next week, Sunday. That is our mandate, to be refreshed ahead. The Lord will bless you as you do so in Jesus' name. Ushers will be giving us this small paper to fill our data, our name, WhatsApp number, and SMS number. Please make sure you put all the information, including your home addresses. The Lord will bless you as you comply in the name of Jesus. The zonal pastor have announced to us during the workers' meeting and the first service, all workers that did not participate are having in the vigil of Friday, workers' vigil. If a worker, a minister, you were not here on Friday, this coming Friday is a makeup vigil. Time is 11 p.m. to 1 a.m. Make sure you are there. I think I was not there, Pastor. So I'm the captain. I'm the captain. And when I'm the captain, I can be strict too. So I'm going to, as you are coming, I snap your picture. The time you came, as you are sharing the grace, I will snap your picture. So I'm a good captain, Pastor. So all of us that were not here on Friday, please let us be here on Friday for makeup vigil. Holy Ghost Congress, Holy Ghost Congress. Let's clap for Jesus. The Holy Ghost Congress is coming around from December 9th to December 16th. The Lord will bless you as you comply. The theme is the great turnaround. Fasting and prayer continues 1st to 30th of November. The Elders Council, the Province 59 Elders Council, they are having their retreat this coming Saturday, 16th November 2019, team, the Fruitful Elders. You can see the banner at the entrance. And they are seeking for assistance from the choir, ushers, and engineering department to please put personnel on ground to make the elders' meeting retreat a very joyful one. Time is 9 a.m. prompt. 9 a.m. prompt this coming Saturday at this auditorium here. Please, ushers, choir and engineering, make sure you have personnel on ground. I will suggest that ushering department and choir department engineering should meet Eda Abegude immediately so as to give him the contact of those who are going to be around and make all necessary arrangements.